Now let's discuss Ohm's law, which will be a natural lead-in from the discussion of how the resistance is defined. And it's in fact just a rearranging of the equation we just introduced for the resistance. So just by multiplying both sides of the equation for resistance by the resistance, we have an equation that looks like this. We have V equals IR. This is telling us that the voltage equals the current times the resistance, but which voltage, current, and resistance is this? If you look at a circuit like this one, it's a very simple circuit. We have a voltage being applied. That voltage is pushing current through a resistor. And we symbolize resistors by the symbol that I've been showing here, which is sort of a jagged line. And it's anything in your circuit that is trying to slow down the flow of the current as it goes through your circuit. So this is a resistor, and we say it has some resistance R in this case. What Ohm's law is telling us is that if we have a particular amount of current flowing through our resistor, the resistor is going to lower the pressure, or the amount of push that we have for our electricity, by some quantity. And that quantity by which we drop the voltage as we go from one side of the resistor to the other, as we move through the resistor, is equal to the current going through the resistor times the resistance of the resistor. So this is Ohm's law. The voltage dropped is equal to the current times the resistance. The current, in this case, as we saw with the circuit, the fluid flow situation, rather, is the adaptable quantity. In other words, for a given circuit, we have some voltage. We have some pump, if you will, some actual battery. And we also have a given amount of resistance. So those are sort of fixed physical quantities, which means that the variable that can adapt to the physical situation that you've given it is the current. So usually what's happening in a problem like this is we know we have a particular voltage, we know we have introduced some particular resistance, and we would like to find what the resulting current will be given this physical system that we've introduced.